We are back again. We are back again to talk about self-care, okay? Because self-care is just something that will never go out of style, will never get old, because you need to take care of yourself in every way possible just so you can be happy, live in the moment, and just spread positivity because you're just radiating it. Alright, so we've got physical self-care. This could be in the form of sleeping, stretching, walking, resting, doing yoga, doing different activities, eating healthy foods that are nourishing you and that do not make you feel sluggish and feel bloated. And just do your research into what kind of foods you should be eating are best for you. Have your treats every now and again, but don't forget to take care of your physical well-being, because what you do on the inside shows on the outside. Emotionally, are you emotionally available? Are you easy to talk to? Are you easy to open up to? Do you open up about yourself? How are your stress levels? How do you manage stress? How do you manage anxiety? Are you emotionally mature, or are you stuck in some traumatic response that you've learned over the years from past trauma that you have? Are you forgiving? Are you compassionate? Are you empathetic? Are you kind? Or do you have an aura that you are unapproachable, that you are mean, that you are negative? These are some things to think about, because a lot of us don't realize until we kind of look and say, oh, why does this happen? Why does that happen? But you need to look at your own self first. Try to do as much as you can for yourself first, and then eventually, hopefully, you will see it pay off with other people. Socially, do you have boundaries? Point blank, period. I walked around with no boundaries whatsoever. And I mean, obviously the boundaries that you have are going to come from past experiences. So at one point in time, yeah, it's maybe good you had no boundaries so you can actually learn to implement them and which ones to implement. Do you have a support system? What does your support system look like? Who are they? What do they do? How do they help you? Do you follow positive social media accounts, or are you constantly surrounded by people you're envious of, or people that just make you feel like crap? You know, there's so many accounts out there that spread positivity, that help others, that help animals, and it's good to follow those pages because it does give you hope about humanity, because watching the news, reading the news every day is very draining. I've been doing it for the past week with everything going on in Afghanistan, and I'm just mentally drained right now because it just breaks my heart what is happening. How is your social communication? Do you cut people off? Do you listen to people? Do you empathize with people? Are you good at responding? Do you get along with these people? How are your interactions with other people socially? Do you ask for help? Are you aware of the different outlets there are for help? Like, a lot of us go through life thinking we're alone. When we're not alone, it's just kind of a response that we tell ourselves so we don't have to get other people involved in our own lives. Spiritual, do you meditate? Do you take time to relax, to calm your thoughts, to slow your breathing? Do some yoga, go out in nature, go for a walk, lay on the grass and let the earth's vibrations and energy and electrons just flow into your body. Do you have a sacred space? Do you journal? Do you let your feelings out somehow? Or do you keep them all bottled up inside? Personal, do you have hobbies? Do you have something that you like, that you look forward to doing? Something that gives you a reason to live, to smile, to wake up? Do you know yourself? Do you know your personal identity? What are your values, your beliefs? What do you stand for? And do you honor these things about yourself? Financial. Do you save money? Do you budget? Do you care about your money? Do you care about your finances? Do you care about your income? Do you care about your expenses? Do you care about your future? Do you care about saving? Do you care about investing? How is your money management? How much are your bills? Are you paying your bills? Can you afford to pay your bills? And how often do you find yourself splurging? Are you aware when you splurge? Is it just in the moment kind of thing, and then you regret it and have buyer's remorse? Or are you able to control yourself and ask yourself, do I actually need this? That is one thing I have improved a lot. before, it seemed like I was buying something every week, but now I've been going months without buying something and just trying to use what I have, use it all before I buy something new. And lastly, work. You have work boundaries. Do you have good time management? Do you know when you should be doing something, what you should be doing, how long it's taking you, if you can improve upon your speed, if you get all your work done, or are you tending to do more work at home? Do you have work boundaries, as in, do you have a set time when you wake up and check your email and respond to people? Like, some people have schedules, 9 to 5, 9 to 6, whatever, they don't respond to emails, phone calls after that cutoff time. Do you honor that? Do you even have that? What does your relationship with your boss or your other coworkers look like? Do you allow them to talk negatively to you, about you? Do you stand up for yourself? Do they respect you? Do you get along with them? Is it a positive workplace? Do they appreciate you? Do they know what they have? You have sufficient break times where you can eat, where you can socialize and just decompress. And lastly, do you see yourself in this workplace? Do you see yourself climbing the ladders? Do you see yourself learning and improving and just becoming a better overall person? Are there opportunities where you are? All of these different aspects of your life are very important, because, especially work, because work is your life, at least here in the United States. I've been hearing a lot of this quote recently, but in the US they say that we live to work, whereas in other countries they work to live, and they have a more better social life and communication and interaction with people, whereas here it's usually work, 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 even on vacation, even at home. So that's why it's good to have boundaries, it's good to have good time management, and know and that you're taking care of each of these different types of self-care, these areas within self-care, to create the best and most positive, happiest, joyous life that you can. I hope you learned something that you can implement in your own life. Please like, comment, share, and subscribe, and I'll see you next time.